Please subscribe my channel for having a proper knowledge in accounts, to fill up the gaps of your misconceptions and to fill up the lacunas of your knowledge, so that you can work out your sums alone without taking help of any private teaching or private tutors.
So, today's topic is Purchase Day Book. You know, Purchase Day Book is the first point, is that it is one of the subsidiary books under special journal. First one, it is the subsidiary books under special journal. Second one, here only the credit purchase of goods or services are recorded. Only credit purchase of goods or services are recorded. For cash purchase of goods and services, we record in the cash book. And very important point, that credit purchase of assets and stationary items, we are not recording in the purchase day book. Credit purchase of assets and stationary items will be recorded under journal proper. And next, from purchase day book, the entries are posted to the supplier's account or the creditor's account. You know, purchase day book is a part of special journal, therefore purchase day book actually is a journal book, and from here those entries are posted to the ledger accounts, that is under suppliers or creditors account, those transactions are posted from purchase day book. Then in short, I'm telling you, purchase day book have these features. It is number one is subsidiary books of special journal, and only credit purchase of goods or services are recorded. No cash purchases are recorded here. Cash purchase will be recorded in the cash book, and credit purchase of assets and stationary items will be recorded in the journal proper. And from here, these entries will be posted to the suppliers or creditors account. We are making a purchase day book, and the entries I am telling you, for suppose number one, on 1st January 2020, that purchased from Mr. X of Mumbai 100 tea bags at the rate of rupees 500 each. Then Mr. X of Mumbai, what you have purchased? 100 tea bags at the rate of rupees 500 each. This means the gross amount is coming to 50,000 rupees. Gross amount is 50,000, and here we have got less 10% trade discount, less 10% trade discount, less trade discount 10%. This means here it will come 5,000, and other taxes or octroi is nil, and net amount will be 45,000. And here in the remarks column, trade discount 10% we can write. It is number one. Suppose next is given on 2nd January, that purchased from Mr. Y, Kolkata. Then Mr. Y, Kolkata, what has been purchased? 100 silk sarees at the rate of rupees 1,000 each. That means 100 into 1,000, that is 1 lakh rupees will come here under gross amount, and less trade discount 10%, less 10% trade discount, that is discount column here 10,000, and also local tax at the rate of rupees 5 per sari is paid. That means plus local tax at the rate of 5 per rupees 5 each. This means 100 sarees has been purchased, 5 rupees per share is local tax, then here it will be 500. This means 1 lakh minus 10,000, that is 90,000 plus 500, 90,500 is the net amount. And here again we should write trade discount 10% and local tax 5 rupees each. Third one is on 28 January 2020 that goods purchased from Mr. Z Delhi. Suppose Delhi, and what has been purchased? 10 fans at the rate of rupees 2000 each. And here trade discount again 10%, then 10 fans of rupees 2000 each, that is 20,000 is the gross amount, and 10% is the 2000 is the trade discount, and octroi, that is plus octroi. Octroi is given rupees 10 each, that is 10 into 10, that is 100 rupees is octroi paid. Then 2000 minus 2000, that is 18,000 plus 100, 18,100 will be the net amount. And here again trade discount 10% and octroi rupees 10 each. In the remark column we should write. Now what we will do, we will add all this gross amount. This column we can add, it will be 1,70,000, and it is 17,000 trade discount total, and 600 is the octroi and local taxes, and this minus this plus 600 will be 1,53,600. This is the total picture of a purchase day book. Again, I'm telling you in short, students, when you will work out this sum, then you will make this chart. Analytically, you can show the gross amount, trade discount, octroi and others, and net amount and remarks column. And if you add all this gross total, and from then if you minus trade discount, and if you add that octroi or other local taxes, then you will get the net. Therefore, you can check before completion of this one, you can check your sum in this way. Check how you can check gross amount is 1,70,000 less trade discount is 17,000 and 1,50,000 is coming plus 600 local tax and octroi 600, that for 1,53,600 net, which is the net amount. you can check in this way also, and your result will be always correct. Thank you.